Do we live in a simulation? I don't know, but MSPC is going to get in one.
Ah! I'm alive!
Simulation of a real hardware may have many use cases. For me, the most important is that I don't always have access to the real hardware. So I decided to create Renode simulation of my MSPC board. Let's go get your favorite drink and watch how I added basic peripherals of Southbridge on MSPC. I was familiar with two hardware simulation software tools. QEMU, which is free and open source CPU architecture emulation, which allows to add board level simulation, but it requires significant effort to do it. SIMICS, on the other hand, offers specialized language to implement full system level simulations. Unlike QEMU, it's not free and probably not even accessible for personal projects. Then I found Renode. It combines the advantages of QEMU and SIMICS. It's free, open source, and designed to create complex system level simulations, where, like in SIMICS, systems are built from blocks. I started from copying auto-generated Raspberry Pico board description from Zephyr. It lacks most RP2040 peripherals, but some basic ones are specified. As I mentioned, Renode boards uses own language and predefined blocks to describe system. I started writing a simulation by creating a machine with RP2040. My first goal was to execute some Pico examples that use UART. So, I cloned the Pico examples repository and compiled examples for the original Raspberry Pico. My simulation should be compliant with that hardware. A few minutes later, I checked with readelf that the entry point of official examples is the vector table symbol. I loaded it inside the first core of RP2040. Unfortunately, that solution skips the bootloader, but nor flash memory is not modeled yet, thus the bootloader can't be used without it. Renode crashed during the creation of a GDB session. Upon investigation, I identified that the issue lies with the CPU ID assignment. I started from the beginning with GDB, since the copied Raspberry Pico simulation lacks basic functionalities. After adding support for GDB inside VS Code, I stepped through execution to identify the first issue. It was a jump to the Bootrom function. The good news is that Bootrom was publicly released by Raspberry. So let's download and model it inside Renode. It's time to verify and seek out next problem. And the problem was that code used single cycle input-output block registers. Specifically speaking, integral divider from that block to calculate frequencies for PLL. It's time to write first own peripheral, which is integral divider. Peripherals for Renode are written in C#. I found one awesome website that provides stub of project for Renode, and thanks to that I can use IntelliSense autocompletion inside Visual Studio Code. There is also a lot of information how to implement own peripheral. If you wanna check that website, link is in the description. CO can be implemented as basic double word peripheral from Renode core. It also has known size, so I inherited known size interface. 1000 in hexadecimal is not fully correct size. RP2040 implements also aliases for atomic operations, but we will cover that topic later. Then it's time to add register addresses. How I know them? From MCU datasheet. There are all necessary information how hardware works, how it's modeled, and how given components impact internal states. I want to add only what I need right now, so I'm going to implement just CPU ID, which is used by startup code to block core 1 from booting, and integral divider registers. Then I add that function that connects registers with actions. Register must define to which operations reacts, like reading or writing, and on which fields. In example, CPU ID is read-only register, which uses only first bit to tell if core 0 or core 1 is asking. And to be honest, that's all what's needed to be done. Now it's time to translate datasheet to the real model. I'm going to speed up most of parts. If you want to add your own simulation, just look to my repository, linked in the description. You also can check Renode GitHub repositories. They have a lot of peripherals implemented there. I want to show only general steps that needs to be done, so I will try to keep focus only on important things. As you have noticed, I added separate class that implements divider operations. And then I created two instances, since each RP2040 core has its own divider block. Similarly to first implemented register, I added once used by divider. C# source files can be directly used by rep files. They can be normally included as others. Renode compiles them on its own. Let's find the next problem. Wait a second, I just resolved that issue. Shit, I forgot to update address map, so let's fix that. Yeah, we went further. Now code stuck in some infinite loop, trying to read unimplemented clocks registers. Clocks are going to be implemented nextly. I decided to not simulate full tree. Clocks tree is quite complex and it's not needed right now. Renode manages virtual time correctly, independently from correct or incorrect clock simulation. GDB, just tell me where we are now. Clock selection still doesn't work properly. The answer why is inside Renode log. CPU tried to write to non-existing peripheral. If you check datasheet, you won't find it inside address map. Those addresses are for atomic access. They are just aliasing memory. Clock's peripheral lies at that address. Then it's aliased by SOR, bitmask set, and bitmask clear. So my Renode log shows calls through aliases. My idea was to implement those aliases as independent peripherals. Each one performs one mathematical operation on original register value. And thanks to that, I can link them to any other peripheral. As I described, each alias has own peripheral inside address map, and links to clock's address. Let's include and check it again. It seems we have discovered new issue. Code stuck on alarms initialization. Alarms are implemented in timer peripheral. Basic timers are already implemented inside Renode. So I just have to adapt them to model RP2040 timer. RP2040 contains a single 64-bit counter, clocked at 1 MHz, which is used by 4 hardware alarms. Only lower 32 bits are used by them. Each alarm contains own interrupt. Timer is the first peripheral that I modeled which uses hardware interrupt. In Renode, interrupts are GPIO objects. I'm modeling all 4 alarms, so I also added 4 interrupts. Then I create a new clock entry in simulation environment and define registers in exactly the same way as in other peripherals. Timer interrupts must be connected to the nested vector interrupt controller on CPU. I connected timer only to the first core, which I'm pretty sure is not correct. But I'm using only first core for now, so I will investigate that later. and the interrupt entries for alarms were taken from the datasheet. Now code try to use pin locks. Let's add them together with FIFO queues used to intercommunication between cores. Both are parts of single cycle input-output. Spin locks I just stop without any core synchronization mechanism. This is to be done when modeling of secondary core. I'm going to add it when it will be needed in some future episode. But FIFO queue is easy to be implemented right now. So I done it using C# generic queue. And we have first successful execution. Or almost successful. Where is next hello world line? Oh, it works, but it's so damn slow. I have to fix that. During off-screen debugging and code clearing, I found that my performance issue was caused by incorrect usage of clearing interrupt on GPIO object. Clearing is not the same as setting to false. And now it's much better. Simulation is only a little bit slower than the real hardware. For me, it's totally enough. Since something is working, I decided to use Pico examples as regression tests for my model. I've added generic initialization scripts for REPT and robot framework. My plan was to use Renode test, exactly same tool that I've used for my dynamic linker series, which just executes Pico examples and verifies their outputs. I showed you only Hello World implementation and I'm skipping REST. You can check them in repository if you want. For now, I was able to add tests for divider, timers and UART.
Maybe I'm not complete, but at least I can speak.
But how do I know that my awesome simulation works correctly? Having verified the basic functionalities of the RP2040, it's time to incorporate it into Yasboot. Looking ahead, I plan to extend the simulation to align as closely as possible with MSPC, while considering my limited time, of course. For now, my focus is on adding the south bridge. Even on real hardware, REST parts remains unusable until the south bridge implementation exists. The task at hand is straightforward. I've already prepared the RP2040 simulation, so all I need to do is add the necessary dependency and write the simulation script that creates the SouthBridge MCU, then load the Yasboot image. Once completed, I can validate the correctness of my simulation by just running it. Wrapping up that episode, I want to say that Renode is excellent environment to create own custom simulation of a real hardware. Thank you for tuning in. I extend my appreciation for each new subscriber and everyone who likes my videos. Let me know in comments what you think about hardware simulation. Is it worthwhile to spend additional time to create it or not? Stay tuned for next episode. I'm already working on it.